I actually love being 34. I love my 30s, which is because it's a different set of confidence, I feel. You know what I mean? When I was in my 20s, yeah, I was confident. I had that, like, cute confidence where I was like, oh, my God, I'm so cute. You're so cute. We're so cute. But, like, if I got all dressed up and I would walk down the street and some guy would catcall me, I'd be like, you're disgusting. This is not for you. That is not why I got dressed up. But now, like, in my 30s, if guys catcall me, I'm like, oh, my God, still? Thank you. Thanks so much. That's exactly why I got dressed up. Thank you. That's amazing. Yeah, I'm getting older. Yeah. So I had to stop doing certain things. Thank God I have a supportive group of girlfriends to help me through this time. Which, by the way, I think girlfriends are so essential. Every woman should have her solid set of girlfriends. Ladies, you need chick friends. You need them. They're your support system. And they'll support you no matter what. You could be crying over a breakup that you caused. Doesn't matter. They're still on your side. You could be sitting there like, but I cheated on him. They'll be like, no, girl, he made you cheat. Don't put this on you. Don't put this on you. We never liked him anyway. There were certain things I had to stop doing, though, with some of my girlfriends. Like, with my younger girlfriends, I had to stop shopping with them because they all go to young people stores. You know what I mean? They all go to, like, Forever 21, which is a great store. It's a great name for a store, too. I want to be 21 forever. I just can't lie to myself and go in that store. You know what I mean? You reach a certain age, I can't go into that store anymore. And I hate when I see, like, 45-year-old women, like, walking out of that store. I'm like, give me the bag. No, give me the bag and walk over to JCPenney like a grown-up. I'll meet you there. There's a sale on cardigans. I do have girlfriends that are my age, that are in their 30s, and they lie about their age. And a lot of my girlfriends are like, oh my God, I can't believe you say your real age on stage. Why would you do that? Why would you say your real age? And I'm like, because it doesn't stop the process if I lie. I don't know if you know how this works. Plus, I can't lie about my age because I'm not that good at math. Yeah. Someone's gonna catch me with that one. They're gonna be like, what year were you born? Hold that thought. I could do it the cheater's way. I have a girlfriend that does it the cheater's way, where she goes, 30's the new 20. 40's the new 30. I'm like, what kind of math are you doing? I don't understand how this works in your head. Really? Because I don't see any 20-year-olds walking around going, oh my God, I'm 10. Guys, this new math system is really messing me up. There's nothing wrong with it. I feel like if you accept your age and not lie to yourself, there's a beauty in that. There's a beauty in accepting it. I have another girlfriend who is now calling herself a cougar. Yeah. Yes. She's like, I'm a cougar. I'm like, you're an idiot. Don't talk in public. Because let me just explain, ladies. I don't know what this fascination is with older women that date younger guys and giving this a name. If you're an older woman that dates a younger guy, I don't judge you. I don't run your life. Do what you gotta do. Just don't liken yourself to a predatory animal. How does that even sound appealing? That one day you will be so hard up for man meat that you have to hunt it. And you gotta hunt the younger ones because their legs are weaker and they don't run as fast. Little baby calf. I'm not even a cougar. I think I'm like bobcat on the spectrum. I was actually recently hit on by a 19-year-old. No. It wasn't sexy. I wish I could say it was sexy. It's not. Here's what happened. Okay, I'm on the bus. All my fun stories happen on New York City subway systems. And this kid comes up to me, and I could see him. You know how you can feel when somebody's about to hit on you? Like, it was like, da-na-da-na. I was like, don't do this. Because I could see him out of the corner of my eye. He's all thugged out. He's like, you know, baggy pants, baggy shirt, like a fitted cap. And here's how I know I'm changing. The second I noticed him, I became maternal. Like, I saw him and I just wanted to iron his clothes and, like, help him out. I was like, this youth needs me. So he came up to me, and I have to give him credit. He approached me with such confidence. He came up to me, he was like, I'm saying, Ma, let me get your phone number. And I was like, no. I was like, why come I can't get your number? Well, let's start with breaking down that sentence, because that is your first clue. So then I said, you know what? I think I'm too old for you. He said, how old are you? So I said, 34. And you could see the damn in his face. Like it was the oldest age he'd ever heard of in his life. And he couldn't fathom how I made it 34 years on this earth. And then he tried to backpedal. He was like, I'm saying, Ma, you don't look 34. And I was like, well, thank you. Should I have like a hump and a lazy eye to help you out? And next time he sees a girl with a hump, oh, she 34. That's when they get they hump.